गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व वी आर गोइंग टू प्रूव द फैराडेज लॉ। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी हैव सीन दैट व्हाट इज द ईएमएफ इंड्यूस पोटेंशियल अक्रॉस द कंडक्टर एंड्स ऑफ द कंडक्टर विच इज मूविंग विद यूनिफॉर्म वेलोसिटी इन लीनियर motion, or we have seen also for rotational motion, circular motion. So we can now at this position that we could do the proof of Faraday's law. So we are going to do the Faraday's law. You are seeing that the magnetic field is showing by the cross sign. It means magnetic field is inside this blackboard, B inside this blackboard, and you are seeing that this is MMOL. You are seeing this strip. This is a metallic path. You can say this is a metallic track. You can say this is a metallic track. This is a metallic track. This is a metallic track on which a conductor is being moved. This conductor JK, this is the initial position, and this is moving. Let's say this is moving with velocity v in this direction. This is moving with velocity v in this direction, and we know that a moving conductor in a magnetic field, a conductor which is moving in a magnetic field, there is a potential difference. But we know that as the conductor start moving, the electron which are present in this metallic conductor JK, which is moving in this metallic track, this conductor JK is moving in this metallic track with uniform velocity v initially, and we know that the electron which is present in this, suppose this is the electron which is present, free electron which is present in this metallic conductor, this electron experiences a force, magnetic force, and the force magnetic, we know that it is F equal to Q V cross B, and for electron this is minus V cross B, Q into minus V cross B, because Q is negative and that will be that I have taken here, Q into minus V cross B. And we know that the force on this, the direction of the force is found out by this particular cross rule, by the right hand rule, V cross B, V is this direction, and we have in place our hand in the velocity. There are four ways, I have already told you. See that particular video lecture many times and learn how you would apply the cross concept so that we can find the direction of the cross product. So in this particular case, because on closing our fingers, the fingers are inside, pointing inside the blackboard, in which direction the magnetic field is. But thumb is pointing in upward direction, but as we are seeing that this is minus V cross B, it means final force on this particular electron which is moving with velocity V along with this particular conductor, the force would be in this direction, not the upward direction, because this negative sign here also. So the force is acting in downward direction, FM, magnetic force. And the magnetic force which is acting in downward direction, because of this magnetic force, electron present, free electron present in this metallic rod, would start moving towards the end K. But as this metallic rod is connected, is touched with this metallic track, it means there is a path for the electron. But in the previous video lecture where we have proved that V equal to BV and sin theta, in that there is no path for the electron to rotate in a particular closed path, but there is a path, so electron will try to come from J end to K end, they would not accumulate at here because there is a path in between, and the electron start moving from here to here, so that the absence, so that we can say the deficiency of the electron there is a magnetic force up to the coil it starts moving. But we know that electron is moving in this direction, there would be a current because this is a closed path and the electrons are moving like this. And we know that there is a current in between this closed path because so current would be opposite to the direction of the motion of the three electrons. So the, in this direction current start, I current, this is we can say I current start flowing from here to here. And also in the metal also. So the current start moving like this. And now the new concept is acting here. We know that this is a current. Now it becomes a current carrying wire. This becomes a current carrying wire also, which is moving. And we know that if a current carrying wire is in magnetic field, if a current carrying wire, this is the current carrying wire, it becomes a current carrying wire. Because the charge which are moving from here to here, from J end to K end, because of the magnetic force acting on the electron, because the metallic conductor, metallic piece JK is moving with constant velocity V, so electrons would try not accumulate here, they would go from here to here to fulfill the deficiency of the electron because of the motion from this end to this end. There is a path. There is a closed path of the motion of the charge carriers, and we know that the current is the current would start flowing this path, and the direction of the current is opposite to the direction of the motion of the three electrons. Now, this is the current carrying coil, and we know that there is a magnetic field. The current carrying coil is placed in a current carrying conductor is placed in a not the coil. If the current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field, there is a force, and that force we know that it is F equal to IBL sin theta. The force on a current carrying conductor is IBL sin theta, and I is induced current here, being magnetic field constant. Theta is what? Theta is the angle between L and B, and direction of L and B is in the direction of L is in the direction of the current, and the current is in this direction, so the direction of L is also along this direction, and L is in this direction, B is this direction, angle between. So we can write here, this is simply I B L because sine and angle is 1. So the force which would act on this particular metallic conductor is, we can say this is I B L. And in which direction this force would act? This is very important. In which direction this force would start acting? Actually, this force is not in picture initially, and as this particular metallic rod start moving with constant velocity V, the phenomena start happening and the current start flowing, and if the current start flowing, a force is start acting on this metallic, in this metallic rod. This is the force due to the current, and we know that the direction of the, this force would be in which direction. We can also write this in vector form. I L cross B. This is F vector equal to I L cross B, and the direction of the L cross L vector is L vector is in the direction of the current. So the current is in the upward direction, so the L vector is also in the upward direction, and the magnetic field is in the inward direction. Just again use the right hand rule, L cross B, put your hand in this way in the direction of L, and close your fingers, it is pointing in the magnetic field direction. So the thumb is pointing here, thumb is pointing in this direction. It means that force, name that force as F dash. Name that force as F dash, so that you would not confuse all the forces F and F dash. This is the force F dash. This force is acting, is not acting in this direction. Before this force is acting on all the this on all the conductor, and which is start acting in the direction opposite to the direction of the motion. It is start acting to the opposite to the direction of the motion. It means it would resist the motion, it would try to stop this particular conductor. The conductor is moving with uniform velocity, and you know that student in the chapter, in the concept motion, and if the object is moving with uniform velocity, the internal acceleration is zero, the net force is zero. And in first case, when this is moving with constant velocity, the net force on this particular JK metallic rod is zero. But now a force start acting on this in this direction at rest, it means there is a net resulting force. And the net resulting force is in direction opposite to the direction of the motion, means it start to stop that motion. So if you want to maintain the object to move with constant velocity v, we have to apply a external force in the direction opposite to the direction of the F-dash. We have to apply an external force. Keep this point in your mind. This is F external. We are writing here, this is F external. This is not because of the magnetic effect. The net action, we have to apply an external force in the direction opposite to this, and magnitude of this is to be equal to this. Equal and opposite force cancel out each other, and object, the net force again becomes zero. It means it would start moving with constant velocity. So we have to apply an external force which is equal to the magnitude in F dash. So what is the F external? F external vector equal to minus of F dash. In vector form, because the magnitude is same, only the direction is opposite, so we can write F external vector equal to minus of F vector. And the F vector is what? The F vector, if we write it in a vector form, and this is from here, minus I L cross B, and we know that this is minus I L cross B is L B, but theta is 90, so this is minus L B. So this is F external minus I L B. F external is minus I L B, means the direction is opposite, but magnitude is same. Now, if the force is acting up to, let's say, distance delta x for the small interval of time delta t, the force is acting, this external force which we have to apply externally to maintain the constant velocity v at a time interval delta t, it means we have to do an external work. We have to do a positive work because we have to apply a force. So we have to do a work, and the work is what? And work is, we know that this is F dot delta x. Because in delta time, delta t time interval, the force was applied, and then in this time interval, this is displaced and reaches at this new position, which is denoted as J as and K as, and this is the displacement delta x in magnitude. So we can say in delta t time interval, the displacement of this JK rod is delta x vector, and the magnitude is delta x, we can say. And from this formula, w equal to f external, w equal to f external, w external equal to dot force dot displacement, and we can write this as f external is what? This is minus I L B, and dot the angle between these two is zero, because f external is applying in this direction, it is displacing in this direction, so the net angle between these two is zero, and we know that formula for dot is A B cos theta and cos 0 is 1, so it is simply I L B delta x in magnitude. This is the work which was done external by the external agent, I L B delta x. What is the L? What is the L? Length. Sorry, what is the delta x? Displacement. We know that this is moving with velocity v, with constant velocity. And when object moves with constant velocity, we would use the formula, simple speed is equal to distance upon time. So, speed is equal to magnitude is equal to displacement, which is delta x, in time interval delta t. So, from here we can say this is delta x is equal to delta t. So we could put this value here. So W external equal to minus I L B V delta T. And I delta T, this is what I delta T. You know that the charge starts flowing, and we have considered Q, V, V, and this is L, and W external. Now, we know that our relations between potential difference and work. The basic formula of potential difference, let's say the EMF induced across this end is V equal to, actually this EMF which was inducing at this end is treating like a EMF of the cell, is treating like a, we can say, terminal voltage, and this is providing a force so that the charge is rotating in a continuous path. So this is acting like a cell, we can say. So V equal to, we can say, this is W by Q, the net charge which is flowing, and this is W work done. And from here we can write here, initial flux is B dot A. What is B? Magnetic field. What is A? Area vector. So this is, you are seeing, this is the plane. This is the plane surface, you can see. And this is B. And in which direction the area vector? Area vector of this. And we can say the magnetic field in this direction and the area vector here, B dot A, either in perpendicularly outward, either in perpendicularly inside. So the flux phi I initial equal to B, which is constant. Area is not constant, because when we move this particular rod from here to here, area will increase. You are seeing here, area is increased, means area has changed. Only what is constant, magnetic field is constant, magnetic flux density is constant. So B A1 cos, let's say theta 1, phi final equal to B, when it is at this position J A, J dash A S, this is B A2 cos theta 2. And theta is the angle in between B and A. B is perpendicular and A is also normal to this particular surface. So the angle is 0. We add the angle 0, cos 0 is 1. So finally phi I equal to B A1, and similarly phi final flux is equal to B A2, because here also theta will be 0. For this plane also theta will be 0, same direction. So BA2, and change in flux delta phi, change in magnetic flux delta phi B, final minus initial. So it would be BA2 minus BA1. If we take B common, this is A2 minus A1. A2 minus A1, you can see A2 is from here to here. This whole region is A2, and A1 is, this region is A1. So if we subtract whole region minus this region, means this is A2 minus. This is A2 minus A1. And what is the area of this particular region? This is delta x, and this is the length, which is, we can say, capital L. So we can say that this is L into delta x. So this is A2 minus A1 is L delta x. Let A2 press. Let A2 press delta x. So delta phi B, finally, what we have, delta phi B इक्वल टू बी एल डेल्टा एक्स अपॉन इफ वी डिवाइड बोथ साइड बाय डेल्टा टी. सो इट इज डेल्टा एक्स अपॉन डेल्टा टी. व्हाट इज डेल्टा एक्स अपॉन डेल्टा टी? इट इज दी वेलोसिटी. सो इट इज बी वी एल डेल्टा फाइव डी अपॉन डेल्टा टी. दिस इज डेल्टा फाइव डी अपॉन डेल्टा टी. And actually, I have taken a small L here. So let's say that this distance is small L because I have taken a small L. So I am confused here. This is the length of this chain, okay? Small L. So this is BBL. This is BBL. Simply, this is small L and BBL. And this is also BBL. So we can say V equal to. We can write here minus V. So it is delta phi B. Upon delta t from these two equations, equation this and equation this, delta phi b upon delta t equal to minus v mf reduced. So v equal to finally minus delta phi b upon delta t. This is the final result and this is the mf reduced, which is equal to negative of rate of change of magnetic flux linked with this particular area. The rate of change of magnetic flux linked is equal to EMF induced, and this is the Faraday law. This is the Faraday law, and negative sign here indicating that the EMF induced is opposing its own cord of motion, and EMF is inducing because of this motion. And you are seeing here the force which is acting in this direction is opposing this motion. So this is also proven from here that the force that the EMF induced is negative and indicates that it EMF induced opposes its own cause of reduction. Because of this EMF, current is flowing, and because of the current, this force is acting. Means EMF induced, because of EMF induced, current is flowing, and because of current, there is a force. This force is because of current flowing, and we are seeing that this is opposing the direction of the motion. So this is the overall proof of